The Philippine State Health and Sewer gets a new president and chief executive officer. Emmanuel Rufino Ledesma Jr. is the choice of President Marcos Jr. to lead PhilHealth. He is already a member of the agency's expert panel and board of directors. Ledesma previously served as president and CEO of the Power Sector Assets and Liabilities Management Corporation, or PESAM. Ledesma resigned from the agency in 2015 after he was given a 90-day preventive suspension over corruption complaints against him by PESAM employees. Meanwhile, dozens of unclaimed cadavers of New Bilibid prison inmates at a funeral parlor in Muntinlupa City will be buried today, Friday. Bianca Dava joins us on the line for details. Bianca, good morning. What more can you tell us?
Hi, Mike. The Bureau of Corrections is set to bury this morning 60 bodies of persons deprived of liberty or PDLs that were left unclaimed at a funeral parlor in Muntinlupa City. The bodies are among the 176 earlier reported that were stored for quite a long time now at the Eastern Funeral Services, the Bucor's accredited funeral parlor. Some of the cadavers have been in the funeral parlor since December last year and even January this year. Now, last November 9, 10 of the bodies were buried at the NBP cemetery. A few have also been claimed by their families. The cadavers that will be buried today, Mike, are among those already mummified or are in a state of decomposition, according to forensic pathologist Dr. Raquel Fortun. 2 weekends ago, Fortun visited the Eastern Funeral Services to conduct an initial examination of the state of the remaining unclaimed bodies. Fortun said only 50 of the cadavers are suitable for autopsy. Based on the Bucor's list, most of the PDLs died of acute myocardial infarction or heart attack, pneumonia and cardiorespiratory arrest, or the sudden loss of breathing and heart function. Others died due to cardiovascular accident, while one inmate allegedly took his own life. Fortun does not discount the possibility of foul play in some of these deaths. Right now, Mike, the wooden boxes containing the bodies of the PDLs are already here at the NBP cemetery. And as we speak, a mass is being held before the burial proper. Mike?
Bianca, just one question. Are you seeing some family members attending the burial? Or are these cadavers actually those of inmates who have not been claimed by their own families? That's why it's the NBP that's burying them at the moment.
Okay. Right now, Mike, actually, there are seats here for relatives and families of these PDLs, but we have not seen any family member here. We're only seeing here the inmates from the minimum security compound who will be carrying the wooden boxes containing the bodies of their fellow inmates to their final resting place. Members of the media and also officials from the Bureau of Corrections. So we're not seeing any family members here. As to the dates of death of these inmates who will be buried right now, the earliest or the longest where the bodies have been stored at the funeral parlor were as far as January 2022, and the earliest was until July 2022, Mike.
And Bianca, any information as to when the autopsy of the other bodies will begin, or have they in fact started?
Mike, as of now, the memorandum of agreement between the Department of Justice and the UP College of Medicine has not been signed yet. So we're also actually waiting for that so that we could get more information as to when the other bodies will be transferred to the UP College of Medicine for the autopsy.
All right. Thank you so much for that update, Bianca Dava.